Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. We're ready to go on Operation Hammer Blade, another supply raid, and this is the team we're gonna go in with. So Emma, Jazz, Ulrich, Yang, Vinny and Cedric, so two grenadiers, two sharpshooters, and then one specialist and one ranger. So we're switching it up a bit, and I'm really curious how this will pan out.
We can gather, resistance forces disabled an advent transport near here, and they've left the gear for us to seize. We expect the aliens are going to move to recover the transport, but it's worth the risk to investigate. We'll need to secure the site, eliminate any hostile resistance, and recover the item.
The text there was a bit off in respect to what he said, but yeah, the wilderness of East Africa. A group of the resistance blocked an enemy transport, and I will be able to, pick up what's left. But I'm starting to feel that we can handle pretty much everything, especially with the new equipment we just got.
This 1-5, the disabled advent convoy is just ahead. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
So I am going to use Jazz as a scout, but as always in these latest episodes, I'm just going to put everybody closer and I'll get back to you once we spot something. And I think Jazz found something already. An officer and a trooper. And there's probably one more where that came from, so I'm going to try and get a bit closer. Oh, and Cedric found something as well. On top here, an Archon and a Viper. Interesting. Ooh, we're gonna have to be careful about this. So yeah, I think we're pretty much set to do what we want. I'm gonna use the proximity mine, because I do want to show how awesome this thing is. So 8 damage. I'm gonna put that over here on top, because these guys are a bit harder to reach. And I can do that without leaving concealment. So if I put it right here, that shouldn't destroy, oh, that does destroy the tree over there. Can't put it anywhere else though, so look at that, doesn't destroy that tree, so I could use that as cover later on. So proximity mine, that doesn't break concealment, which is really really good, and once those two start moving, they're gonna be in for a surprise. Because now I can actually freely take a shot at the troopers over there with an incendiary bomb. Maybe I shouldn't even. I could actually just do saturation fire. Look at that. Oh, stop doing that. Jesus Christ. This is really hard to aim. Because for some reason he's... Yeah, like this. Yeah, okay. So this should allow me to fire on all three of them. It only takes 3 pieces of ammo and does 8 to 10 damage. Fire on all targets in a cone. This is actually really nice to start it off with. Ulrich, why don't you do the honors? Oh, this is awesome. Blam! There we go. What? Are we revealed? That is so wondrous. One of the guys is burning already, and these guys are gonna just... Well, they're gonna be pissed, and then they're gonna... Explode! Goodbye, Viper! That was lovely. That was really, really lovely. Dan... Oh. You guys might have made a big mistake. Because I think I'm probably able to kill all of them now. Or don't I? Ooh. That's just outside the reach of the officer, but yeah, let's see what everybody else can do, because this seems pretty easy. I could even do face-off. He sees... Huh. If I move over here, I probably see, because the one I'm missing now is probably the one behind covered area. The trooper. The trooper over here. So I think... I'm gonna just move him over here.
Seems doable.
There we go. Oh no. That is weird that I don't see the one Because it's a straight line, he should be able to see the trooper there, but... Yeah, first, let's try a lightning reflex on the Archon. And that misses. No biggie, no biggie. And then I'm just gonna use face-off and try to kill as much as I can. Light, face-off. Not lighting hands, face-off. That's a miss. That is a hit. He's not aiming again, but never mind, he killed the Lancer.
Not too shabby.
I could guess now that the officer would die from burning damage, but I don't really want to take that risk. What I do want to do is put Emma a bit closer, maybe. Still have a lightning hands of in Cedric's arsenal as well, so might as well try that on the Archon. 5 damage. He's gonna be even more pissed, probably. Then we have 100 at the trooper, 78 at the Archon, and 86 at the officer. I am gonna try and kill the Archon here, because that's the biggest threat at the moment. Ooh, that was right over its head. Annoying.
Adjusting sights.
Yes, indeed, you should. What else do we have? We still have 4 guys left here, so shouldn't be that big of a problem. And I think I'm gonna use Emma to do a skull mine, because we're low on intel and these guys usually have intel. I think the officer is in the thickest, so let's run towards him and try and stab him in the neck. Small cache of intel or facility lead? Yeah, let's go for the small cache of intel. There we go, easily done. Thank you very much. Oh, that sound. I do love that noise. Ooh, that sectopod. I keep hearing that sectopod, which is really unnerving me. But now, what does a sword attack do? 83, and it might actually kill the Archon. That is not such a bad idea, actually. Come on, Jazz. Come on, Jazz. Come on, Jazz. I know you can do it. Slash! I think that's the first time I killed an Archon with a melee weapon. And now we need to kill... Ooh. That is unexpected. Oh, shit. I might not be able to kill that thing. Oh, I might from over here.
Sure thing.
And I'm gonna spot something else and everything is gonna go to hell. No, I can't see anything from here. God damn it, what? Oh. I do want to make sure I kill that guy, but yeah, I can't really hit him from over here. Oh, damn it.
Keep the pressure on.
Doesn't that... Oh, come on. Okay, no biggie. He just left, which is not that bad. So I am going to move further and see what we can find. Although, do I want to use Jazz for this? I could reconceal Jazz and go forward with him. There we go. Let's just move in this direction. Doesn't seem like he found something. So let's move Yang over here. Oh, does he actually see him? Yeah, okay, there he is. There he is. Cedric, would you do the honors of taking that guy out? Because he's a bit of an annoying piece of shit. Goodbye. Hopefully he didn't destroy that loot crate over there. We didn't. Not too shabby indeed. Thank you very much. And promotion for Cedric. I think that makes him max level as well. So let's move him. Do I move him closer? I don't think I should. I'm going to use his autoloader. And then just stay here on Overwatch. We don't really have a timer, so let's take this easy. We used a few shots, so we don't really need to hurry this up. This should be safe, I think. And then Ulrich over here. And everybody else on Overwatch. Jazz on Overwatch, Vinny on Overwatch, Emma on Overwatch, and Ulrich on Overwatch. Okay, there we go. There we go. Sectopod, Shield Bay, and Officer. or something else. That's sad that that missed. That was a good one, although the 5 armor, of course, eats that up. Okay. So I think it's a Lancer, the bad guy. Come on, Ulrich, shred that armor. Damn it. Stop damage. That's sad. So yeah, a Lancer, a Shield Bear, and a Sectopult. Okay, no biggie. I think... How big is the blast radius of the Blaster Bomb? No, 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 no. Oh, come on. I didn't even get a... Yeah, that was something. And that was... A Yang also has the acid bombs. Okay. That was a very nice one. I didn't even get a prompt. I didn't even get the circle. So that's why I was really, really confused. But that armor needs to go. So... Ulrich... Can you use your Shredder Cannon? I think he can. Ooh, I'm gonna have to aim this really, really well. So I don't think I can hit the Lancer without hitting the... Yeah, without hitting the loot. I'm gonna probably blow up the truck, but that shouldn't blow up the loot crate in the back, I hope. But this seems like it's... very, very nice. So let's do... That!
You're shredded!
Shredstorm Cannon! Whoa! Okay, so that's cool. I think that killed the Shield Bear in one hit. Didn't that damage the Lancer over there? Apparently it didn't. And that does count as an action that's free if you hit. That's actually really cool. So fire again at the Sectopult. Shredding that last bit of armor. Goodbye! Yeah, I think we got this easily. It's really weird that that Lancer didn't take damage, but yeah. Lightning Hands on the Sectopod. Blammo. 10 damage. And it's almost done for. So let's now use... Ooh, do we use Face-Off? 74 on the Lancer. 59 on the Lancer, but I could get... You know what? I'm just gonna do Face-Off. Kills a Sectopod guaranteed. And we still have Cedric with a shot to kill the... oh no! Yeah, there goes the loot, goddammit. Because of the Sectopod explosion. That's too bad. That is too bad.
Watch those supply crates. If you destroy them, there won't be anything left for us to recover.
Oh, shut up, Ratbutt. Yeah, bye. That is not the last enemy, though, if I'm not mistaken. There should be 2 more, yeah. There we go. So let's put him on Overwatch. And then let's put Jazz inside of the loot, because, yeah, he's still in concealment. And maybe he spots something. Oh, shit!
Let me see où je suis.
That is a problem. Illyrium Core, that's really good. Superior Laser Sight and Alien Data Cache. Oh god! They're low level enemies, which is good. Oh, goodbye. Free melee attack because he came too close, and then of course Cedric's Overwatch shot. 6 damage added. Wow, that Archon is almost done for. And then we have... What happened to the other guys? He's even burning the Archon. Where are those other guys? Can I do something? Hello? Okay, I can shoot, but... What the hell? Okay, there we go. Oh yeah, because the Blade Storm probably counted as an attack. So there's 2 more sectoids. Sectoids are pretty easily dealt with in melee, because we do added melee damage. So yeah, there we go. 100% to kill. And with a 10 to 12 damage, that kills them instantly. So I could kill this last sectoid if I'm able to kill everything else with everything else we have. But that's kind of the issue right now. We don't have that many shots left. I am going to use Emma. What does combat protocol do? 6 damage. So that's the Archon done for. Because he can't dodge that. Because it's guaranteed damage. Goodbye. So that's the upgraded gremlin that does that. And now I think I'm just going to use the mimic beacon just to be safe. I'm going to put the mimic beacon... Okay, what the hell is going on? There we go. I'm going to put the mimic beacon over there just to make him a very nice target for those sectoids. And that should save us. Holy shit, didn't expect there to be three more enemies. Ooh, critical. Oh, that's only 5 damage. Never mind. And then the other sectoid is going to try and harm the mimic beacon as well. And another 3 damage. They don't do all that much damage, apparently. Then we should have... Emma. Yeah, Emma. Go, Emma. Behind full cover.
I'm on it.
Because we need to spread those promotions around a bit. So, Emma, fire at that sectoid. You might not kill it. What the hell? Ah, that's this... That's the staff of the Archon that's right in front of her face.
That is not good.
That's not that bad, Emma. Don't you worry your pretty little head about it. 63 or 60... No, 43. So let's try 63 on the sectoid. Goodbye! And then we only have one enemy left. So we're gonna be able to deal with that rather quickly with the sword. So Jazz, sword attack on the sectoid. Taking it out, guaranteed. Goodbye. And there we go. That is such a freaking cool animation. Just putting that sword in his back. Promotion. Yes, thank you very much.
Holding position.
So 9 turns for 11 enemies. And that was a flawless round. There we go. I do love the music you get when you get a flawless mission. So Ulrich dealt most damage. Ulrich also made most attacks with his amazing abilities by now. And then the Mimic Beacon was under fire most, and Jazz moved the furthest because of his PCS chip. We also got a new record in average damage per attack, which is a whopping 9 damage per attack. So yeah, we're becoming really, really powerful. Operation Hammerblade. Complete, and that's actually a really fitting name because he did use the blade a lot. Arriving back at the Avenger, and I think we have 2 promotions at least. So Cedric got a promotion and Jazz got a promotion. Oh, and Emma got a promotion as well. So Emma. Ooh, lightning reflexes. Each turn, the first reaction shot against you misses. That is actually pretty good. Hidden ability uncovered, and that was the last one she could get as well. And with her, I am going to go for capacitor discharge, because with those upgraded gremlins, that can do a lot of damage. And she's Colonel already as well. So that's, I think we're gonna have to buy some more rookies. I think it's high time we do that. And then Jazz, he's not Colonel yet, so he has one more rank to go. Deep cover, if you did not attack this turn, hunker down automatically, which is really bad, especially if you can compare it to untouchable. If you score a kill during your turn, the next attack against you during the enemy turn will miss. So that makes him pretty much invincible after he kills somebody with a sword, which is really good for Jazz in particular. So yeah, there we go, untouchable. And then Cedric, his final ability, Serial or Fanfire. So Fanfire, as you can see, would be a really, really good ability for Vinny with the EMP rounds. But Serial, a powerful chain shot ability. For every kill made with your sniper rifle, your actions will be refunded. So as long as we kill enemies, we can continue firing with the sniper rifle. Pair that with his, incredible aim and his autoloader, that should make for an incredible combo. So yeah, Serial is a passive ability. So here we go. Thank you very much. That's 3 promotions in the back. So Yang is still available for promotion, Jazz as well, and Vinny as well. So we're gonna start having to include a few rookies if you want to keep leveling up soldiers, but that's not gonna be so that much of an issue. Look at that, 3 Illyrium cores. I think we're gonna build a few more war suits, if you catch my drift. So superior laser sight, which is also really, really good for shotguns. Alien data cache, and then a lot of wrecks. 91 alloys, 57 crystals, 179 supplies, and 20 intel because of the hack we did. with Emma. So thank you very much. Having recently discovered an alien data cache storing valuable enemy intelligence, I can dedicate my team's resources to decrypting the files and ensuring that we recover the large amount of intel stored within. So that's a research project we can do to... because we are at low intel. That's a research project we can do to get ourselves a bit more intel. But we did get a bit extra, so 78 intel is our current tally. And I think we have a few extra things we need to do.
You've done a hell of a job keeping this ship together, Doctor.
It's all we've got. And I know the aliens aren't happy about losing one of their own.
I doubt they thought anyone could get this heap airborne again.
I'm more than happy to prove them wrong.
Thank you, Shen, indeed. Because this is one hell of a ship. So let's go to the recruitment screen. I'm going to pick a few from the character pool because I think they're in here somewhere. Yeah, there we go. They're all in the bottom here. So we have the rest of the Ruby characters. We have Zoltan from The Witcher as well. And Donald Trump, for some reason. Yeah, one of my colleagues from work actually added Donald Trump. So might as well get him in. But we're lacking a few women, I feel, in the team. So let's pick Allison Church. There we go. Let's go back to the bottom of the list and go with... I think Ruby would be a nice pick. And then maybe, do we go for Donald? I think Zoltan, maybe go with Donald. There we go. Let's go with Donald Trump for some reason. Don't support the man, but yeah, there we have it. And then we have, you know what? We have so much supplies. We might as well go for Zoltan as well. There we go. And let's build those guys up because I want to do... Yeah, I want to go to the Guerrilla Tactics School and put at least one of those guys in there. I can't actually upgrade this to add more soldiers. So we're going to start with Allison. Let's put her in there and let's... do we build her up as... All of our specialists are now max level, so we could go for another specialist. Although we only have... two good rangers at the moment as well. But I think extra grenadiers are always handy. There's a trophy you get for completing a mission with all the same class, so I could go for grenadiers and just build out six grenadiers and leave it at that. But do we go for grenadiers? Or do we just get another ranger? I'm gonna start with another ranger, there we go. Also gonna go to the new combat tactics school and choose some new tactics. Deathrot bonus 10% chance to critically hit enemies, which is really good, of course, because it's a passive buff. For the first two turns in battle, why not, eh? We have the supplies. So let's get Deathrot and Cool Under Pressure. And maybe even Lightning Strike, who knows? Why not? Still have 400 supplies left after that, but you know what? I do want to go to the Proving Grounds as well and start building a few more extra things. No, let's not swap out the Gremlin. But let's go with another... I really like those war suits, actually. So let's go with the war suits.
I'll send word as soon as we're finished, Commander.
And then build one more experimental powered weapon as well to add to that war suit. Yeah, why not? Plasma Blaster, that's something else. Using technology adapted from the aliens' own plasma weaponry, we've devised a means of releasing a massive focused pulse of plasma energy, that will devastate targets in a fixed path. One Plasma Blaster has been added to the inventory. How many of those powered weapons are there? Because there's a lot of them, apparently. We still have one left. Do we make another raid suit? We do reduce the amount of items we can carry when we do that, and I don't think we benefit from another raid suit. So do we just go for another ammo type then? Because I think we're still missing one more ammo type. Tracer rounds. Containing high-tech smart rounds that relay detailed tracking data back to the shooter when fired. This specialized ammo adds plus 10 to the shooter's aim when equipped. Huh. Interesting. Might actually put that on one of the guys or girls. Let's go back to the bridge. Increase region income. That's always nice, but I think we're pretty good on that account. So we were making contact with New Indonesia, so let's head back there.
Setting course
Wow, that was close. The UFO just passed right next to us.
Excellent. My analysis of the fragmented codex data is almost complete. The information I've uncovered so far outweighs the loss of the Shadow Chamber, as you'll see.
Is that an Elder? Haven't seen one in at least a decade.
Yes, and I believe I now understand why. The Elders appear to be afflicted with an aggressive form of tissue degeneration, rapid muscular atrophy, to a degree I had not even thought possible.
So they're dying. Sounds like our job just got a whole lot easier.
As with most things involving this adversary, it's never quite that simple. The Elders have been aggressively searching for a cure to their condition for centuries. Each time they encountered a new species, they procured what genetic information and material they required and moved on to the next world. Until now. I believe they found something in us. Something important enough to cause them to take root.
A cure?
Not that I can determine. Several key files were previously deleted as part of something called the Avatar Directive.
Avatar. We need those files.
Were I to gain access to a fully functioning codex, I might be able to recover them.
Or blow the entire ship to hell this time around.
I didn't say I needed the creature here, Bradford. I am confident I could access the unit remotely, provided your soldiers can get close enough to it in the field without destroying it first.
That we can arrange, Doctor.
So there we go, our next objective will be to... Skulljack, a frickin' codex. So use the Skulljack item on a codex alien in combat to gain access to restricted data from the Avatar Project.
It looks like we've got our work cut out for us, Commander.
With time set aside to further analyze the data fragments left over from our initial codex experiment, I finally managed to crack their code, and the resulting data is perhaps more valuable and shocking than I had expected. I understand now why the codex was willing to sacrifice itself to protect this information. In the shadows, the alien overseers, known to us as the Elders, have continued to work in secret since the very beginnings of Advent. Although Central Officer Bradford tells me that no one has seen an Elder in the flesh for over a decade, we continue to see monuments in their likeness throughout the city centers. This is because they never left. They simply fell into the shadows, focusing their efforts on a more dire concern. The Elders are dying. Among the diverse and widely varied alien specimens we've encountered, the Elders are uniquely afflicted by some form of rapid muscular degeneration. That was a tough word. Their physical forms are no longer capable of containing the psionic energy that is the Elders' lifeblood. Just as we've encountered these unique alien species in the field at some point in the past, the Elders encountered them as well, and used them in an attempt to cure this plague among their own kind. Unfortunately for them and for us, it seems they never found this cure, and now it appears they are looking to use humanity as their next candidate. So yeah, that gives us the motive we've been looking for quite some time. The aliens are still here because they found the cure to heal the Elders from their deadly disease. And they're gonna process a lot of humans in the process to get everything they need. And it's all contained inside of the Avatar Project, so that is why we need to stop it. Now we're gonna change this again and research the psionic gate. Only needs 10 Allegiant crystals and a bit of supplies. So there we go, that's our next objective that we're starting to examine. What else can we do? There's someone in the Guerrilla Tactics School, which is good. Warsuit is going on, so yeah, let's head back to the bridge. Because we're pretty much done with making contact. There we go, New Indonesia. It apparently is snowing in New Indonesia. That is... strange. I don't know much about Indonesia, but I would think that it doesn't snow there all too often. But there we go, Vigilo Confido. The people of New Indonesia stand ready to help XCOM however we can. There we go. So we could go over there, but of course we want to reduce the contacting cost. And we're gonna build...
Commander, that UFO contact has us locked in. We have to take evasive maneuvers.
Okay, so this is what I was afraid of. We have to begin evasive maneuvers. Which means as much as the... Well, the Avengers is gonna try and evade the UFO.
Setting course for sector.
But that is probably gonna fail. Because yeah, he's gonna start following us. And yeah, there we go. I wonder if the turrets are gonna change this, but I don't think it will. Because we're taking fire.
We've lost power! We're going down! Fast!
Impossible! There's no damage to the engines! Unless... must be using an electromagnetic pulse. If I can just bypass all this alien circuitry... Hold on.
Shen?
Not accepting the transfer. Interface ready. The system is overriding my command.
Shen!
Right.
And just in time we regain our flight capabilities and don't crash down.
Emergency power online.
This is so freaking awesome, but
someone get me a damage report.
I wanted to avoid this.
Only one?
They've just dropped some sort of spike outside. It's generating the same type of pulse that knocked us out of the sky.
They don't want us. They want the ship.
There we go.
Isn't there some way you can override it?
Not from here. I can't get our engines online while it's out there.
Commander, we're gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. Destroying that spike is our only chance at getting out of here. We can't let the aliens take this ship.
And that is
down,
exactly.
Commander. UFO contact has disabled our systems. Brace yourselves.
Our next objective. We need to defend the Avenger from any attacks. So Operation Summoned Corpse. The Avenger is under attack and must be defended at all costs. Ready your troops, Commander. Because yeah, we're going to be sent out with our best soldiers for now. And they're going to start. It's kind of like the base defense from the previous game. And we need to head out of the ship and destroy that spike they put outside. Really annoying, really tough mission, because they keep spawning enemies as long as we don't destroy it. The turrets should help us keep the aliens from the door, because if they reach the ship, it's game over, permanently. The game is completely over. Our complete playthrough is finished if we don't complete this mission. No backups, no saves, everything is gonna be done if we don't complete this mission. So, I don't know exactly where I can save here, because I do want to take a little break, of course. So can I go back? I can't go back, so let's begin mission then. Oh, yeah, okay, there we go.
Commander, we can't afford to let this operation get away from us. Even if it means sending our wounded forces back into combat, we have to succeed at all costs.
So this is a safeguard in, well, in the scenario that we wouldn't have enough soldiers to get them out there. So in order to ensure the success of this vital operation, wounded soldiers may be assigned to the mission. We don't have wounded soldiers at the moment, which is really, really good, of course. But I do wanna take a look at the entire squad. So let's edit a few of these guys, because I do wanna make sure that our best troops are equipped with everything we have, because these six are not the only ones that are gonna join the fray. We're gonna have to equip everybody we have with the tools we have available to us. So that actually means I think I'm gonna go back. Can I actually build items? I can. I can actually build another Skulljack, which is sad. But I might actually go for another blue screen rounds, since we have a bit more supplies left. No armor, that's not really necessary. Could make another mimic beacon. And maybe another medkit as well. I think that's gonna be enough. We kinda know what we expect. So let me figure everybody out here for a second. So we're gonna have to hit them hard and fast. So Jazz is definitely on this squad, this starting squad, so we can push him ahead of everybody else. It doesn't appear. Oh, I. No. but I can't save right now. So I'm going to start the mission immediately now. And you know what? No, I'm going to take a little break and just continue this in the next episode, but just continue recording. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And next up, we're going to try and defend the Avenger from the UFO that's going to keep dropping enemies at our doorstep. So see you guys in the next grueling episode. Goodbye.